Dear students, welcome you to the second semester BSc Physics class. In this session, under the chapter Low Temperature Physics, we shall discuss about the ideal gas and real gas, Van der Waals equation of state. In kinetic theory of gases, we have come across about the ideal gas and real gas concept. What is an ideal gas? Ideal gas is that gas which obeys gas laws at all the conditions of temperature and pressure. But a real gas is that gas which does not obey gas laws at all conditions of temperature and pressure. So there is a restriction for the real gas to obey the ideal gas equation. At very low pressure, the forces of intermolecular attractions are negligible. All the gases will have a force of intermolecular attraction in a high pressure. But at low pressure, the intermolecular attractions are negligible. Therefore, only at low pressure a real gas obeys the equation PV is equal to RT. An ideal gas can be defined as a real gas at low pressure. That means at low pressure, ideal gas can be deviated or it can be defined as a real gas. For a real gas, the internal energy is a function of pressure and temperature. For all practical purpose, real gas below a pressure of 2 atmosphere can be considered as an ideal gas. So now let us look into the difference between ideal gas and real gas. In case of ideal gas, there is no intermolecular force of attraction between the molecules of a gas. But in case of a real gas, there is intermolecular force of attraction. In case of ideal gas, the volume occupied by the molecules is negligible. The volume occupied by the molecules is negligible as compared to the total volume of the container. In case of real gas, the volume occupied by the molecule is not negligible. It is not negligible. There is some volume we can calculate. Ideal gas cannot be liquefied, whereas real gas can be liquefied under some conditions. For an ideal gas, the equation of state is given by PV is equal to RT, where P is the pressure of the gas, V is the volume, R is the gas constant, and T is the absolute temperature. For a real gas, the equation of state, it is a modified equation, which is known as Van der Waals equation. So that is given by P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. So these two are the correction factors we will discuss in the next slides. In case of ideal gas, internal energy depends upon only the temperature. The internal energy dU is equal to CV into dT. In case of real gases, the internal energy depends upon temperature as well as volume, because volume is a considerable factor in case of real gas. So therefore, the internal energy dU is equal to CV dT plus A by V square dV. So where CV is the specific heat capacity at constant volume. Now, We shall discuss about the van der Waals equation of state, and we can deduce an expression for the van der Waals equation of state. In the deduction of equation of state of an ideal gas PV is equal to RT, it was assumed that the size of the molecule of the gas is negligible. Also, the force of attraction or repulsion between the molecule is also negligible. The experiment on Andrews, Amagat and others showed that the equation PV is equal to RT does not describe the true behavior of actual gases except in some conditions. The perfect gas equation is based on the assumptions of the kinetic theory of gases. Those two assumptions have to be revised in order to explain the behavior of real gases. Hence, in 1879, van der Waals made some corrections for the perfect gas equation PV is equal to RT. He applied corrections for intermolecular force of attraction and finite size of the molecules. Because ideal gas equation PV is equal to RT is derived by neglecting the intermolecular interactions of the gas molecules and neglecting the size of the molecules. But in case of real gases, the molecule will have intermolecular interactions and also they have a finite volume or size. By taking into considerations these factors, van der Waals made the corrections for the pressure as well as the volume for the perfect gas equation. Now, we shall look into the correction for pressure which was made by van der Waals. Here you can look into the figure. Here in a vessel, gas molecules are filled or present. Consider a molecule A. It is well inside the vessel and it is attracted by other molecules around it in all the directions. So this arrow shows that there is a force of attraction between this molecule A and the other molecules around it. Hence, since it is attracting all around it, the resultant force or the net force acting on it is zero. Let us consider the same molecule in this position A dash, which is very near to the wall. When it strikes the wall at this position, the molecular force of attraction is less. Some molecules will pull back this molecule towards the inner side, but there are no molecules in the side of the wall. So there is a less pressure applied by this molecule on the wall of the container. Therefore, its velocity and hence momentum with which it will strike the wall would be less than the momentum with which it will strike in the absence of the force of attraction. This is true for all other molecules approaching the wall. This reduction in momentum results in decrease of pressure. In other words, we can say the observed pressure of the gas is less than the actual pressure. the correction for the pressure P depends upon number of molecules striking a unit area per unit time of the walls of the vessel and the resultant inward pull of cohesion on each of the striking molecules. Each of these factors depend on the density rho of the gas. Hence we have the correction for pressure P is proportional to square of the density. Rho represents the density and the pressure is proportional to square of the density. Since there are, if there are more molecules, the density will be more and the pressure will be more. Therefore, the correction for the pressure P is proportional to square of the density. It is in turn proportional to, inversely proportional to V square. Since rho is equal to M by V, we can say rho is proportional to 1 by V. If P is the absorbed pressure calculated on the basis of kinetic theory, assuming the absence of intermolecular attraction, we can give the actual pressure exerted by a real gas is less than this and is equal to P is equal to P plus A by V square. So where A by V square is the reduction factor. Hence we can give the pressure for real gas is equal to the ideal gas pressure minus the reduction factor, that is the reduction in pressure. Now we shall look into the correction for volume. As the gas molecules have finite size, they occupy a definite space. As a result, actual space available for their movement is less than the absorbed volume of the container. By taking this into consideration, the sphere of influence, by using the concept of sphere of influence, we can understand this concept for the correction for volume in a better way. So here in the figure, a sphere of influence is shown. The dotted line, what here showing is the sphere of influence. The sphere of influence is drawn by taking a radius of 2r and taking the center of the molecule. So here A with the radius r represents the molecule, and by taking twice the radius of the molecule, we can draw a sphere of influence. So in the sphere of influence, no other molecule can penetrate. So therefore, this much volume will be unavailable for the molecules inside the vessel. So therefore, there will be a lesser volume for the molecules when compared to the total volume of the vessel. This is considered by Van der Waals, and he made a correction for the volume term. Therefore, due to the finite size of a gas molecule, the actual space available for the moment of the molecule, movement of the molecule, so there should be a correction for this term, movement, movement of the molecule, is less than the volume of the vessel. The molecules have the sphere of influence as shown in the figure around them. Volume of the sphere of influence of each molecule is given by S is equal to 4 by 3 pi into 2r cube, that is equal to 8 into 4 by 3 pi r cube, that is equal to 8x. Since x is the volume, we can say x is the volume of the molecule, that is pi r square, pi r cube. The volume of the sphere of influence will be 8 times the volume of the molecule, that is S is equal to 8x. Now, let us fill the whole space of volume V with n number of molecules, one by one. The volume available for the first molecule is equal to V, because V is the volume, total volume in the vessel. For a first molecule, when we want to fill the vessel, the entire volume is available for the first molecule. Next, the volume available for the second molecule will be lesser, that is equal to V minus 8x, that is equal to V minus S. For the second molecule, how much volume is decreased? So S is the, we have S is the volume of the sphere of influence. So this much volume is reduced for the second molecule to be filled inside the vessel or the container. So now our average space available for each molecule can be given by, so this V plus V minus S plus V minus 2S plus etc. V minus n minus 1 into S divided by n. So this is for the average space available for n number of molecules inside the vessel. Therefore, average space available for each molecule can be given by V minus n into S by 2. That is equal to V is equal to 4 into n into X. We can rewrite this as V minus B. So where B is a constant, which is known as the van der Waals constant. Thus, by making corrections for the term pressure and volume in the ideal gas equation, van der Waals arrived at a new equation. So that is given by P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. So here these two are the two terms made for the pressure and volume corrections. So therefore A by V square is the pressure correction term and B is the volume correction term. Thus, van der Waals equation for state of a gas is P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT.